Now I'm going to do a demonstration that illustrates how chemists discovered an interesting phenomenon in chemistry, enantiomers. Enantiomers are what we call chiral molecules, and they are mirror images of each other, but they are not the same molecule. Your hands are chiral molecules. If they were molecules, your hands are chiral, because if you have a left hand and a right hand, they're mirror images, but they're not the same. If you try to place them on top of each other, the fingers and thumbs don't match, or the palms don't match. Okay? So they're two different molecules, but they're related by the fact they're mirror images of each other, but not the same. Now, how did chemists come about discovering this? It was very difficult, because for chiral molecules, almost all their physical properties are the same, except for one. And now we have to talk about light. Light is called electromagnetic radiation. It's called electromagnetic radiation because it has an electric wave and a magnetic wave, and they run perpendicular to each other. Like one runs horizontal, one runs vertical. And you've heard of polarizing filters, maybe polarized sunglasses or polarized filters for cameras. And I put a polarizing filter on there, and if we look at... Let me turn off the lights here. We might get a better look-see. So there's our overhead projector without the polarizing filter. Okay, so there it's pretty bright, and now we put the polarizing filter on and it's somewhat dimmer. Why? The polarizing filter has taken out one of the waves, either the electric wave or the magnetic wave, and I don't know which, and it doesn't make any difference. Now here's an interesting thing, okay? If we put another polarizing filter on and it's oriented the same way, nothing happens. But watch what happens as we start turning this second polarizing filter. So what I'm doing now is I'm turning a second polarizing filter around. And lo and behold, the light's gone. So let me show you what I just did. Okay. We'll come back down here. So that's the being projected. We're going to come back down here. Okay, here's my second polarizing filter, and I am going to slowly rotate it, and lo and behold, you still can see a lot of light there, but if I come back up here, where the projector is, there's absolutely no light going through. All right, let me show you. I have an old pair of polarized sunglasses, and you can see, again, see it very much the same way. When they're oriented in one direction, there you can see right through them, and now I'm going to turn them that way, and look, blocks out the light. Again, because one polarizing filter takes out the electric wave, the other polarizing filter takes out the magnetic wave, and that takes out all the light. So, how did this relate to chemistry? Well, here's some what we call Karo syrup. It's just a sugar syrup. And we're going to put it right there. Okay. And now I have to find my polarizing filter again. And we'll put it on top, and it's oriented the same way, so no problem. And we start twisting it, and we start twisting it. We get it perpendicular, and look. There's still light getting through where the Karo syrup is. The Karo syrup is doing something to the polarized light. What's it actually doing is rotating it or twisting it, okay? And this shows us that this is a chiral molecule, and it has an enantiomer, and that's the only property that differs in enantiomers. If we rotate this very slightly, okay, we can now block out the light from the going through the Karo syrup, but the rest of the light's getting through. I have rotated that polarizing filter, and that's what an enantiomer does. An enantiomer rotates polarized light, plain polarized light. If this was the mirror image of the molecule in there, it would rotate the light, the plain polarized light, in the other direction. And this led us to discover the concept of enantiomers, which are very, very important in chemistry, because it's like a right hand only fits in a right glove. It doesn't fit in a left glove. And many molecules are like that. Most of our biomolecules, proteins and sugars, are of one version, not the other.